have with us Ms. Pallavi Pratap. Welcome to BW Business World. My first question to you is, what are the major key takeaways from your panel?
I think one of the biggest takeaway that I, and actually a learning that I had from my panel, was about whistleblowing in India. Because we've typically seen whistleblowing in movies that, you know, it looks like a certain way. But in corporate world, I think whistleblowing has been shown as a very important component to check if there is corruption that's happening, if there are, you know, things which are being misreported. And those, I think, like the panelists told us today, there is some kind of a protection which is given to the whistleblowers, and that they are able to then therefore come out and report to the management that these are the problems that they are facing. So I think that was the biggest takeaway for me personally, because I was completely unaware that, you know, this kind of a huge system prevails as far as the corporate India is concerned.
So do you think that, you know, whenever a whistleblower come out and then, you know, speak about something, do you think that India utilizes that information to its full potential, or there is a scope to it to utilize the information from whistleblower and take actions against certain companies or people?
I think that goes from company to company. MNCs, I'm told, they are very gung-ho on whistleblowing. So they are they have these audit process where they are checking these whistleblowing you know, informations that are coming, and then they are cross-checking and finding it out. But a lot of Indian companies, which are led by which are promoter-driven, there I think the whistleblowing is not really taking up its shape, because any employee who wants to come out with truth is scared of saying it. So I think that cultural shift is there. Yeah.
So a persecution of white-collar crimes on the rise. So how do you think these things impact the India's business ecosystem?
Not just the business ecosystem, if you ask me, you, I, every one of us, like the panelists told us, that white collar crime also includes cyber crime. And those, all of us are actually vulnerable in that sense. So the corporate world definitely has a larger stake there. And therefore, the persecution has to happen. But I think there is a delay in terms of, you know, from investigation to final persecution, there is a lot of delay. As a result of which, we see that right now there is at least a spike as far as the offences are concerned.
So thank you so much for your time. Lovely speaking to you. Thank you so much.